Hello everyone and welcome to my video. This is a birthday edition because it is my birthday. So today I'm going to work with one of my newest additions to my family, the Revolution. The Revolution Reloaded Marvellous Mats. So let's see what we can come up with. So first up, I'm going over with my NYX Total Control Drop Primer. I really love this primer because it becomes like a sticky consistency over the face, which will be really helpful later on when we're applying our foundation. So next we are going over with our Revolution Conceal and Define Foundation, and this is in the shade of F5. This is actually my third time of buying this foundation just because of the COVID going around. It's really hard to test makeup products because they've gotten rid of it throughout the stores. So third time's the best, and it actually suits my tone, which is really great because I just can't keep on collecting foundations. So next up, I'm going over with my Revolution Supersize Conceal and Define Concealer. I do not know what color it was because I don't remember it, but it is really nice and creamy. And another tip for you guys, if you want to have a great nose line, just draw a straight line on your bridge of the nose and just blend it out where it is, and it should leave a nice nose line. Next, I'm going over with my NYX Cream Contour and Highlight Palette. I really like this contour palette because it's just nice and creamy, like it says on the packet, and I just kind of use it to contour out my cheekbones. And if you do not know how to contour out your face, just make a fishy face and suck it in, and wherever the cheekbones are, you want to go under that. And don't forget to also apply a little bit under that chin just to get rid of that double chin that you may have. So going in with this little brush, I'm going to use it to contour out my nose, and going on the sides of my nose and underneath it, and just drawing a little line on the bulb of my nose just to make my nose a lot more rounder on the tip. And then I'm also going to apply a little bit under the mouth to make my lips bigger. Next, going over with my NYX Stay Matte But Not Flat foundation. This is a bit brighter than what I'd usually buy, but I'm actually using this foundation as a pressed powder to just set in that concealer that I applied earlier, and it just kind of brightens the face also. Then going in with my favorite palette, the Melo Cosmetics Stardust palette. It has four shades, two highlighters, one blush, and one bronzer. So I'm going to use my bronzing brush and use the bronzer to just, wherever I applied the contour earlier, I'm just going to kind of sculpt my face a little bit more. You finished with your face, you want to squeeze the brush if you don't have a nose contour brush and just kind of sculpt it out with the brush itself. And if you've gone too overboard with your nose, just grab that brush earlier with that powder and just kind of swipe it off a bit more just to make it a bit more natural. Just going in with a fluffy brush, I'm going to apply the blush from that palette earlier, and I can honestly say that this palette is really pigmented and a little goes a long way. So I'm just lightly brushing it all over my cheek and a little bit on my nose. Then using my highlighter brush, I'm just going in the color Luna as a highlighter. And this highlighter is the bomb. It's really sparkly and you can see it straight away. And a little, like I said earlier, goes a long way. And I just like to go on the sides of my cheek, on my nose, and on my Cupid's bow. So So after our face, I like to do my brows, and I'm using the 24 hour super brow pomade in the color medium brown. And first of all, just gonna brush out my brows and then apply a little bit on the lower part of my brows, and then just kind of shape up the top part. And then of course after that, you want to brush it out to just finish the look. Same concealer that I used earlier, I just want to clean up any inconsistencies to my brows that I drew earlier. Going over with my Fenty Beauty Amplifying Eye Primer. This is just to help our eyeshadows later on, just to make them stick a lot more onto our eyes. Going in with the palette, I'm going to look for the closest shade that matches my skin tone and apply all over my eyes, just to kind of set that eye primer. So with this palette, I really wanted to use most of the colours, so I went in with a little brush and tried to put in the yellow shade, but it didn't seem to work, so I used my finger and it worked perfectly. So I started to apply it onto my inner part of my eye, and I'm going to create like a little rainbow. Then finally, going in with a brush, I'm going to apply the orange shade and just kind of blending it next to the yellow shade that I applied earlier. And after applying my orange shade, I'm just going to pat on that red color. And I can honestly say that the Revolution palettes are really pigmented, so a little goes a long way. So I'm just trying to pat in that red and kind of blend it in with the orange. After applying the red, I'm going to go in with the pink to just finish the upper part of my lids. And I really wanted to push that pink out from the sides of my eyes, just to kind of make it a lot more dramatic. And later on, I'll be cleaning it up with a little bit of concealer. Like I said earlier, I was going to clean up my eyes a bit, so I'm just going to kind of follow out the sides of my eyes and make a straight line. And going in with that tiny brush again, I wanted to use a lot more colors, so I went in with the dark colors. So I started off with the blue, followed by the purple, and then using the green to finish it off. Next, I'm going over with my L'Oreal Paradise Kajal or Kajal Ecstatic Eyeliner in the color of white, and I'm applying it on my lower lash line. Going in the palette again, I'm going to apply the white eyeshadow onto the inner corners of my eyes to kind of brighten up my eyes a bit more. And going in with a crazy idea that came up to me, I am using the NYX white eyeliner to just kind of follow out that wing eyeliner look. And the problem with white eyeliners is that you cannot make mistakes, and I made lots of mistakes because I'm not really good at doing eyeliners. So let's just see what we get. Next, I'm going in with my next color mascara in the color of Coral Reef, and I thought I might use this onto my lower lashes, and it became like a little rainbow of colors all over my eyes, and I found this color being really, really cute. Then an important step before applying mascara is to always curl your lashes. I usually curl my lashes for about 10 to 12 seconds, and once I see that curl, that is done. A unique Moonstruck Epic 4D Lash Mascara. I really love it. It's not clumpy. It's the best mascara ever. Going in with these lashes from Eyelook. It made this look amazing. So now I'm using my lip liner to guide me later on to where I should put my liquid lipstick. I'm using the Revolution Matte Liquid Lipstick in the color of Ballerina. I found this color to be so cute, and the things with this liquid lipstick from Revolution is that it's really creamy and it seems very watery, but once it's on, it dries nicely. So this is the final look that I came up with the Revolution's palette, and all those colors are really lovely, and even my parents strange. But anyway, I hope you guys like this video. Leave a like, subscribe, and comment down below if you have any questions or just want to say hello. Bye guys. You're perfect, you don't need no filter. Go just make them drop dead, you a killer.